Assalamu alaikum, wonderful people. I am Dr. Asma Mahmood, and today we will make golden milk. It is a natural remedy which has been used in Ayurveda since long. But today I will tell you the variations to do in your golden milk if you are, say for example, on a keto diet, if you are a diabetic, or if you suffer from an autoimmune disease. So stay with us till the end, because today you are going to get a wonderful recipe that will get rid of all the diseases that you have. And we'll start right after the intro. Double or quadruple this recipe as per your requirement and store it in the fridge for 7 days. But today we'll make 1 cup. For 1 cup we need 1/2 cup of water and 1/2 cup of milk. Traditionally in Ayurveda, the golden milk is made with the dairy cow's milk. And if you have a dairy cow's milk that is not hormone infested, that has no chemicals or preservative, go for it. But the thing is, you need 1/2 cup of milk. Okay, if you are suffering from an autoimmune disease or any other inflammatory disease, you should be using A2 milk. What is the difference between A1 and A2 milk? Basically, A1 milk has A1 casein in it, which is inflammatory, while A2 milk, which is traditionally derived from goats, has A2 casein. The A2 casein is less inflammatory and it does not cause inflammation. So people suffering from any autoimmune disease, multiple sclerosis, Hashimoto's thyroiditis, ulcerative colitis, any other such disease, should be taking A2 milk instead of A1 milk. Make sure if it is like goat's milk or sheep's milk, that is understood it is A2 milk. In the cows also, there are some breeds which produce A2 milk. Make sure that if you use that one, it is a good breed and it is not like hormone infested, because even if it is A2 milk and it is hormone infested, it is still bad for you. So make sure that the milk that you're using is the best quality milk. If, however, you are doing a keto diet or you are diabetic, you need to use a low carbohydrate milk. So you can use coconut milk or almond milk. Both of these milks are easily available. Make sure that if you get a canned version, the can is BPA free. Thirdly, if you are not doing keto diet and you are not diabetic and you do not suffer from any autoimmune disease, you can use regular 1/2 cup milk. And that 1/2 cup milk should not be hormone loaded. It should not be powdered milk. That should not be processed or tempered milk. Make sure that it is hormone free milk, and preferably from grass fed cows or grass fed animals. In this you will add 1 teaspoon of turmeric powder, or you can also, if you have fresh turmeric, add about 1/2 inch piece of turmeric in it. The turmeric is a very beneficial spice because it has an active ingredient called curcumin. This curcumin has been researched and it has been found that it is rich in antioxidants. It is a super anti-inflammatory. In fact, a research was done. I'll read out the research for you. One study in 45 people with rheumatoid arthritis found that 500 milligrams of curcumin daily reduced joint pain more than 50 grams of a common arthritis drug. Okay, see, so this reduces the arthritic pain. It is a natural painkiller and one of the best things to have because it does not have the side effects of the painkillers. Usually when people take over-the-counter NSAIDs or painkillers, they suffer from acidity, bloating, gut issues. You know, these things are not present with curcumin or turmeric, because turmeric has side benefits. Instead of the side effects, it has side benefits. So the turmeric is also, as I told you, turmeric is anti-inflammatory, it is antifungal, it is antiviral, it is very good for your depression and anxiety because it increases the BDNF. And I have tried it myself. To boost the benefits of curcumin in your turmeric, just add a pinch of black pepper. Black pepper has piperine in it. This piperine, when it combines with curcumin, it increases the efficacy or the absorption of turmeric to 2000 times. So with the same teaspoon, you will be getting 2000 times more benefits if just you add a pinch of black pepper in it. Okay. In addition to this, you will add in your golden milk, you need to add 1/2 teaspoon of ginger powder. If you are using fresh ginger, you can add just 1/2 inch of piece of ginger. Ginger powder again is very beneficial. I'll read out the research for you again. So this is a 6-week study which was done in 247 people with osteoarthritis, and those given ginger extract
had less pain as compared to those who were taking the regular pain medication.
Wonderful, isn't it? The next ingredient is half a teaspoon of cinnamon powder. If you are using cinnamon sticks, add a small stick of cinnamon. Cinnamon itself lowers sugar, it controls the blood pressure as well as the cholesterol level. You see, these are things in sharp contrast with the medicines you take, which has side effects. These have side benefits in them.
Sure. Now, this is the traditional Ayurveda golden milk. When I make golden milk, I usually add 1/4 teaspoon of kalvanji or black seed powder in it also. This is my kalvanji powder, and I have basically roasted the kalvanji or the black seeds and just ground them. And I add just 1/4 teaspoon, and this 1/4 teaspoon has been found to not only reduce weight, control sugar, it is also good for people with cholesterol levels, high cholesterol levels. If you are diabetic or doing keto, you can use stevia or any other safe sweetener like erythritol, monk fruit. If you are, make sure that it is free of any other artificial sweeteners, okay? If you are not doing keto or you are not diabetic, like for your grandmas or granddads, you can add honey. A teaspoon of honey is very good and it tastes wonderful. Traditionally, this is all that is needed for the golden milk. What I do is, in my golden milk, once it is prepared, and before I pour it into the glass, I just put one egg in my glass. I just give it a good whisk. And then I add my golden milk to it. Once I add the golden milk to it, then it becomes a protein-rich golden milk. Now, this is a wonderful start of the day. You know, it has all the antioxidants. It is rich in protein and it tastes wonderful. Really, you guys must try it. If you take it before bed, you will get a good night's sleep. If you take it in the morning, you will have a wonderful day, because of all the antioxidants and the anti-inflammatory qualities that I just told you. If you are a coffee drinker or a tea drinker, you can add these ingredients to your coffee or your tea and it will become a boost of antioxidants. Like in your coffee or tea, just add 1 teaspoon of turmeric, 1/2 a teaspoon of ginger powder, 1/2 a teaspoon of cinnamon powder and a pinch of black pepper, and 1/4 teaspoon of kalvanji powder, and it will become a powerhouse of antioxidants. So let me know in the comment section below if you made this milk or this tea, and how much you liked it, and how much your grandma and grandpa liked it, and how much your mother and father liked it. So till we meet next time, take care. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.